Good morning, everyone. About an hour ago, there was a magnitude 4.2 earthquake. Here we have a live view of Old Faithful. GeyserTimes.org has a note, says event non-geyser related. A magnitude 4.2 earthquake at the Azuraca range between Little Sandal Mountain and Castro Peak. Using Google Earth, here's the location of the 4.2 on the right. There was an aftershock of a magnitude 1.5. Off on the left here is the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. This is the area where, 4 years ago they found dead trees that were laying on the ground had burned up because of the heat of the magma coming into Yellowstone. Burn them up, turn them into charcoal. We have Fern Lake up here, and this is the area right here. This image is from 2015. These burned up trees are no longer there. They had died because of the gases coming up, fell to the ground, and the heat literally turned them to charcoal. I have three monitors here. The one on the left is the borehole. Borehole 207. This is the monitor for Maple Creek and the monitor for Lake Butte. Yeah, all the monitors picked up this 4.2 earthquake. It was actually a 4.3. There's its seismic signature, and I'll bring it down and show you that it was actually a magnitude 4.38, almost a 4.4. And then we'll look at its spectrogram. Okay, it shut down. There we go. Okay, this is the borehole. You can see the hot gases that were coming up. Just before the earthquake struck, the popping of the ground, this is in the upper magma chamber. All right, and you can see here how the magma chamber goes off towards the northeast. Let me make that bigger. And hold on. We have the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. Notice the flow towards the direction where this earthquake occurred. And the upper magma chamber goes down below 10 kilometers. And then we got the magma reserve. This earthquake was 8.7 miles in depth, or 14 kilometers. This is significant. So far, 15 people have reportedly said they felt it. They gave it an intensity level of 5. So that would mean a conduit opened up, more likely. Pressure built in the magma reserve. A crack, a tube, a conduit opened up between the magma reserve into the upper magma chamber, which means we got a flow of magma coming from the plume of the magma reserve rising up. And it evidently is on the move. Here is the stream view. Yeah, look at that. Drum beats. This is the borehole at the top, the borehole. We got more popping of the rocks. The middle one is Maple Creek. And then the bottom one is Lake Butte. See that? Blobs of magma coming into the system. This is those drum beats I was talking about there at the borehole for Yellowstone, or the Madison River. Boom, 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 boom. This is the same, let's go to the signature. This is the same drum beats right here for what I downloaded to the borehole. And this is what it was showing shortly afterwards. And then look at that, more drum beats continuing from when I pulled the files. All right, Lake Butte. reason I'm looking here is because I've talked about that crack at the bottom of Yellowstone Lake, which has got a cap of rhyolite preventing the lava, which is called magma when it's still under the ground, preventing it from coming up. And this lighter color is the line of melt. We got a smaller earthquake right there. Right there. And I wanted to look at the line of melt. The ground there at Yellowstone is very brittle. It would not take a large earthquake to trigger an eruption, such as an earthquake on the outside rim of the magma chamber. The outside rim doesn't or hasn't had the pressure, the uplift build up to make the ground so brittle as it has there in the center of the caldera. All right, let's bring this out. Drawn out in red, that is the outside edge rim from 2015, where they figured the caldera was. So this is on the outside edge of the caldera, supposedly, which we know is not true. I need to update this because of new research, which shows we got a northeast trend of the small arm of the upper magma chamber. There has been 40 smaller eruptions since its last major eruption 640,000 years ago. But there was another eruption just 70,000 years ago. They found the lava flows there on the Pitchstone Plateau. There has been 3 extremely large explosive eruptions that have occurred at Yellowstone in the past 2.1 million years, with a reoccurrence of the large one. Now, this is just super eruptions, about 600,000 to 800,000 years ago. More frequent eruptions of basalt and rhyolite lava flows have occurred before and after the large caldera forming events. For example, scientists have identified at least 27 different rhyolite flows that erupted after the most recent caldera eruption. And they have a link about the ash from the different eruptions. Here's the Yellowstone Plateau, Mesa Falls ash bed, and the fallout. Yeah, all the way over here, we got North Dakota, Kansas, Nebraska. It's currently 9:52 a.m. Central Daylight Time. This is what it's currently showing. And this is the borehole 207. I want to extract that to see what's going on. Yep. And we'll take a peek here at the live webcam. So, yeah, something to think about. And any volcano actually could erupt within 10 minutes with little or no warning whatsoever. And they're hoping there at Yellowstone that they would get earthquakes like this as a warning. And let's take a peek. It's now up to 16 reports. There's no reports that have been sent in to EMSC, but they're saying it was a magnitude 4.4. Yeah, that sounds more logical than a 4.2. Like I said, what I got when I was calculating was close to a magnitude 4.4 also. Felt reports came from as far as close as Helena and Cody, Wyoming. Intensity level from Gardner. Yeah. 5, meaning just about everyone felt it. Some breakage of dishes. Windows might have cracked. Plaster broken. Disturbance of tall objects. So that one report about 24 miles from where the earthquake occurred, you can see here, distance 39 kilometers, which would be about 24 miles, which very well could be in this area here. These are the first houses that I could find said they felt it really good. Possible breaking of windows, things knocked off the walls, cracks in the plaster. All right, let's go out. That is the closest area that I could find. And we'll come out and come out. Okay, right there. And then the earthquake occurred here. That's probably where the intensity level of 5 came from. I really wish USGS would actually let us read the felt reports. I bet it scared them. What do we got here? I don't know. Anyways, don't forget Sunday night, we got the blood moon. I talked about that. I think it's just going to be a bad sign. People ask why. Well, the moon is in the phase of Scorpio, and it kind of reminded me of the Bible, where it talked about the invading armies and having the sting like the tail of a scorpion, wearing breastplates of iron. And that will be Sunday night. I did a report about the blood moon that's coming up. The eclipse. We're going to have a total eclipse to be able to view here in the United States. So, what are your thoughts? Earthquakes increase during lunar events. It's going to be a super moon, which means the moon will be closer to the Earth this time of the year, which will create more pressure, create more earthquakes, and possibly volcanic eruptions. And I mentioned all that in my report. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your support. We got several new people who joined me on Patreon in our community. If you wish to support my work, you can join me there on Patreon. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you.